Greetings to our CUFI family across America and around the world. Today, I'm talking to you about living under pressure. St. Paul has written in 2 Corinthians 4, "We are hard-pressed on every side, yet not crushed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed." Paul lived under pressure. We are living under pressure right now in America. Great pressure. Our economy is shut down. Millions are unemployed. Our dreams for the future are being systematically crushed. We have been forced to disconnect from the people we love via social distancing. Our bars are full, and our churches, by government order, are empty. It's obvious the government considers bars essential while the house of God is cast aside. It's a position I will not forget the next time I go to vote. People we do not elect to public office are now telling our elected officials what to do. America and the world are upside down. All of this social and political madness has given birth to the thought that brings me some comfort: the benefits of pressure. What's the difference between a priceless diamond and a lump of coal? A sparkling diamond is a lump of coal that made good under years of pressure. The trouble it endured made it priceless. God likewise presents us trouble and pressure to develop us, to make us better than we ever dared dream we could be. St. Paul wrote in 2 Corinthians the words I have just read: "We are troubled on every side." Trouble was coming from the north, the south, the east, and the west. It was coming from Christians. It was coming from the Roman government. And Paul says to the church, "We've got big trouble, but we won't let that stop us. We will prevail. The victory will be ours." Those are thoughts you need to have. We're perplexed, but not in despair. We're persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed. The fact is, we serve a God that is bigger than all the trouble in the world. And in this, we are more than conquerors. St. John wrote in chapter 14, Jesus speaking, "My peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives to you, not but such as I give unto you. Neither let your heart be troubled or be afraid." We can have the peace of God that surpasses all understanding, even in the midst of life's most vicious storm, because Jesus is there. It helps to think of trouble simply as resistance. Without the resistance of wind, a bird cannot fly. Without the resistance of water, a massive ship cannot float. Without the resistance of gravity, you can't walk. The petals of a flower do not share their perfume until they have been crushed. An olive will not yield its oil until it has been pulverized. Trouble is the womb where greatness is born. People who follow the world's ways want an easy life, free from all trouble. But that's not how maturity is developed. Maturity is developed in God's university of adversity. He strengthens us in our troubles to make us more valuable to the kingdom of God. Jesus proved his sonship by being strong, patient, compassionate, forgiving, loving, and perfect through every trial and persecution he faced. When we can face life's greatest challenge with the mindset that all things work together for the good of them that love the Lord and those who are called according to his purpose. Romans 8:26. Listen, according to his purpose. Are you in trouble? Have your finest plans for your life come unraveled? God is shaping you to reach your destiny. Press on. Press on. The victory is ours in Christ the Lord. Amen. That's God's word for today. I'll see you this Sunday morning live via internet at sacornerstone.org/watch or on Facebook at Hagee Ministries at 8:30 a.m. Central Standard Time. I'll see you Sunday morning. God bless you and good night.